Hello everyone, welcome to Video Lecture Series of Communication Engineering. Today's topic is Delta Modulation and Adaptive Delta Modulation. In this video, I'll be talking about the multiple choice questions based on Delta Modulation and Adaptive Delta Modulation. You must have studied these two topics, but just to recall you that you are aware with the pulse code modulation, which is the PCM. And in case of PCM, you have studied that PCM transmits all the bits which are used to code a sample. It means signaling rate and transmission channel bandwidths which is required that are quite large in the case of PCM. And to overcome these problems, delta modulation is used. So let us discuss the questions based on these two topics. Let us begin. First question is, delta modulation uses space bits per sample. How many bits per sample? 1, 2, 4 or 8. So delta modulation is used for analog to digital conversion and vice versa, and it is a simple form of differential pulse code modulation, and it uses 1 bit per sample, and it also depends upon the difference between the current and previous sample values. This is what you are aware with. Means it uses 1 bit per sample, means the answer is A, the correct one. Question number 2 is, granular noise is associated with PCM, DPCM, DM or QAM. So granular noise that is associated with delta modulation means that is DM. So answer is C. In the case of delta modulation, you must have studied that there are two drawbacks, means two different kind of noise which may occur, that is granular noise or slope overload distortion. Question number 3 is, the digital modulation technique in which step sizes varied according to the variation in the slope of the input is known as. You have studied about the delta modulation and adaptive delta modulation and the difference in between these two. In the case of delta modulation, step size is fixed, while in case of adaptive delta modulation, step size varied according to the variation of in the input signal. Means the answer of this question is B, the correct one. Question number 4, the digital modulation technique in which step size is fixed is known as. So when the step size is fixed, the type of technique that is known as a delta modulation. So answer is A. Question number 5, the technique in which step size is not fixed, that is known as, I've already discussed in the previous question, step size is not fixed in the case of the adaptive delta modulation. So answer is B, correct one. In adaptive delta modulation, the slope error reduces, and what is the impact of on quantization noise? Quantization error decreases, increases or remains same. So when slope error reduces, the quantization error increases, vice versa, means answer is B, the correct one. Question number 7 is, in DM, that is the delta modulation system, the idle noise occurs when the modulating signal. See, idle noise is also known as a granular noise. So it occurs when modulating signal increases rapidly, remains constant, decreases rapidly, or the nature of modulating signal has nothing to do with the noise. You must have studied that granular or idle noise, it occurs when the step size is too large in comparison to the small variation in the input signal. So when there is a small variation in the input signal, it means input signal is varying very less or it remains almost constant, but staircase signal is changed by a large amount, that is by delta, because that is the step size. That is why this type of error introduced. It means when modulating signal remains constant. Answer is B, the correct one. Question number 8, Consider the following statement comparing DM and PCM, delta modulation and pulse code modulation. DM requires, delta modulation requires a lower sampling rate. No, this is not correct. A higher sampling rate. Yes, this is the correct one. Means 2 is the correct one. Third is a large bandwidth. No. And fourth, simple hardware. So, which of this statement is correct? Out of these four, 2 and 4 are correct. Means higher sampling rate and simple hardware. So, the answer will be A, the correct one. Question number 9. In DM system, the slope overload distortion occurs when dynamic range of input signal is large, dynamic range of input signal is small, modulating signal remains constant, or pulse amplitude increases. So, slope overload distortion, it arises because of the large dynamic range of the input signal. What happened? There is a large dynamic range of the input signal, means input signal amplitude is increasing a lot, but because the step size is too small, that is fixed for the staircase signal, so it is not capable to follow the segment accordingly. Means here the answer is A, the correct one. Question number 10, delta modulation is conversion. Which type of conversion? Analog to digital, digital to analog to digital, and digital to analog both, and none of the mention. So, delta modulation is the process of analog to digital and digital to analog conversion technique, which is used for the transmission of voice signals. Means answer is C, the correct one. Question number 11, to achieve high signal to noise ratio. Here we are talking about high signal to noise ratio. Delta modulation must use undersampling, oversampling, aliasing, or none of the mention. So to achieve high signal to noise ratio, you must be aware aliasing must be avoided. It means oversampling is required. Correct answer. Because aliasing and undersampling, they are going to reduce the signal strength. Signal quality will be deteriorated. Question number 12. The demodulator in delta modulation technique is, what is the demodulator? So the demodulator which is used in delta modulation, that is actually a simple form of the integrator. So answer is B, correct one. Question number 13. Source of noise in delta modulation is granularity, slope overload, granularity and slope overload, and none of the mention. So the sources of noise, these are granular noise or idle noise and slope overload noise. Means the answer is C, correct one. Question number 14, in delta modulation, 1 bit per sample is transmitted. Yes, this is correct one. All the coded bits used for sampling rate transmitted? No. The step size is fixed? Yes. It means A and C are correct. Means the answer is D, the correct one. Question number 15. In digital transmission, the modulation technique that requires minimum bandwidth. What is the answer? Delta modulation, PCM, DPCM, or PAM? So the technique which uses minimum bandwidth, that is nothing but the delta modulation. So answer is A. Question number 16 is, in delta modulation, the bit rate is n times the sampling frequency, n times the modulating frequency, n times the Nyquist criteria, or none of the above. So in case of delta modulation, the bit rate is n times the sampling frequency, n into fs. Means the answer is A, it is correct. Question number 17, to overcome large requirement of signaling rate and transmission channel bandwidth, which technique is used? Definitely, these are the drawbacks in the case of the PCM. So the technique which is used, that is the delta modulation. So answer must be A. Question number 18 is, maximum signal to noise ratio of delta modulation system is, this equation you must have derived. If not, then you can do the derivation. So If you have done the derivation, you will pick the answer very easily. This is nothing but C. It's 3 upon 8 pi square fm square fm ts cube. So this is the equation or the expression which shows or which represents maximum signal to noise ratio for delta modulation. It means answer is C. Question number 19. Bit rate of delta modulation is given by bit rate or signaling rate. This is the same thing. So delta modulation bit rate, that is denoted by R. It is what? Number of bits transmitted per second. So that is denoted by FS. This is the correct one. How to calculate the number of bits transmitted per second? It is nothing but the number of samples per second into number of bits per sample. So that is how you are getting FS. Question number 20. Signaling rate is also known as, this is just now I have discussed in the question number 19, bit rate or signaling rate. This is the same one. Yes, the correct answer. Question number 21. One disadvantage of adaptive delta modulation over linear delta modulation is that it requires more bandwidth. It is more vulnerable to channel errors. It requires large number of comparators in the encoder, and it is not suitable for signals with periodic components. So the disadvantage of adaptive delta modulation is it requires large number of comparator in the encoder. This is the major drawback of the adaptive delta modulation. The correct answer. Next and last question. To overcome slope overload problem, which type of integrator is used in the delta modulation? What is the nature of integrator which is used so that the slope overload error can be reduced? Fixed slope integrator, variable slope integrator, linear slope integrator, or bipolar integrator? So there is a requirement of a variable slope integrator because it is used to change the step size according to the variation or according to the nature of the modulating signal, right? So here it is capable to change the step size, therefore variable slope integrator is required. Means answer must be B. Let us check. This is the correct answer. Thank you so much for watching this video.